Hello and welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Bart and today I'll be reacting to some of the Eurovision Song Contest 2024 songs. You know, your boy's busy. I didn't really have time to record myself react to all of the songs individually. However, I've decided that I still wanted to react to all of them somehow. And I thought it would be a good idea to divide it into three parts and do, you know, the big five and then the first and the second semi-final. And also I believe this is going to make this quite a close experience to how regular people watch Eurovision. Like, I don't consider myself a hardcore fan of the Eurovision. However, I think it is a slightly different experience for me because usually I know the songs and I know the stories behind them and I know the lyrics and everything. This one is going to make it a little bit more organic and natural. So, without any further ado, I think we can get to it.
I just realized I was not recording the entire song. Anyways, as you can see by my face, I really loved the Italian song. I'm just very sad that you won't be able to see my first reaction to it. But anyways, I'll watch through it once again. I'll just summarize everything that I just said about it. I love the fashion. That's what I remember from it the most. I love the idea of the song. I really enjoyed like the style of this music video. I enjoyed the style of the song itself. I said that I was very excited about it, and I was very excited that this is the song that we are starting this Eurovision journey for this year, because it was like, you know, energetic, but at the same time, I guess there is some meaning to it. Like, I don't speak any Italian, but I would very much like to learn what the song was about. I just wanted to say that actually I'm to some extent happy that I have an excuse to watch it again. It's not the first reaction, it's the second reaction, but still I'm very happy that I got to see it again. I love that, you know, this is kind of like rapping. But then you've got this more sensual and more ethnical? Is that ethnical? Ethnical part. It's very modern. And I love her. Like, her personality is everything. She's so sassy. And like, you cannot stop watching her. This, it reminds me of Albania a few years back. But at the same time, it's completely different, of course. I like this idea very much as well. And I'll also say the same thing as I said the last time around I was watching it. This is definitely not the last time I'm watching it. This part makes me think that it's not as happy as it seems. Like, I'm intrigued, I have to admit, I'm very much intrigued by this song. And I want to learn more about it. I'm in love with it, total. We actually have France. And as I've said, I have already reacted to this song, so I'll just add the clips from that evening.
Okay, let's go.
He speaks French, so he'll be able to translate, I guess.
Yeah, I just sing words, so that's not too much. Okay, when I hear the piano in the first seconds, I'm a little bit... well, not interested, but let's go. Let's see. Let's
but you
wait.
Like power ballads.
Yeah, I like, but this one, I can it be more dramatic? I don't think so. He's trying his best to be the most dramatic as is possible. So, thank you. Next. Anyway, let's go.
To be honest, I really like the camera work. I like the way the video is being shot.
Doesn't it scream to you like Barbara Pravi? Like
it,
she
it
did.
Does.
Yeah, like this front camera with the lights behind her. So it looks familiar. Okay, let's
and
talk
also
here.
A little bit like Epidemo as well.
Yeah.
But at least you cannot deny it's French.
Well, yeah, of course. it sounds French, it does.
And it looks French. France in the Eurovision.
Okay, so you know, you can see all the camera angles, all the simple gestures, all his face expressions. I'm just waiting for him to cry because that's the only thing I'm missing right now from being this over dramatic. But okay,
the song itself is
it's pretty Eurovision. It is? It's like a typical power ballad?
Well, I have to admit, we've seen that. We've seen
And
disco ball turning person.
Oh yeah, especially recently, we've seen it several times. And we don't need a French song to hear Je T'aime, because it's already pretty universal, and singers from other countries also use it, so...
But it's like super dramatic.
Super dramatic, over dramatic. But as for the first song released from this year's Eurovision, from next year's Eurovision, I think it's decent. I mean, I'm not gonna hate it. I'm not gonna love it. I'm just gonna accept it and give time
to it.
Yeah, and give time to maybe like it even more. So far, not too bad. Good attempt. Let's see other countries. Well, the thing is that between you and me, you're the one who focuses more on the lyrics, and I'm the one who focuses more on the music. I don't really care about the lyrics. I don't need to know the meaning of them. But the thing is, musically, the song is okay.
Mm.
If I was more focused on the lyrics, if I could relate to the lyrics, I think I could like it even more. For now, as for the first attempt, as for the first listen, I think it's okay.
What I can see is missing a little bit is the fact that there is no explanation of what the song is about. You can't really understand.
What's the title thinking. Anyway? Mon Amour, okay. Like,
it's very general.
It couldn't be more cliche.
It's not helping.
It couldn't be more helping. Cliche. Especially because the title is included in the first lyrics of the song.
Yeah.
Because the first lyrics he says is Mon Amour.
Yeah.
Nice falsetto.
Like, vocally, I think he's really good.
Pretty okay, yeah. I think the biggest issue will be to stage it properly.
Mm.
And stage it the way that people will like it. Because, this, like we said, the song is okay. But, okay, is it enough for your vision? And... from what I understand from what he's singing, the lyrics seem pretty simple.
Mm.
Without any, I mean, of course it has a deeper meaning like every, like most of the songs, but as for a usual listener who doesn't speak French so well, it doesn't, you know, draw me in.
Mm-hmm. In my mind, I would say the song is okay as well. I would say that I really enjoy the way that he sings,
mm-hmm.
because I very much appreciate the fact that he can sing so well. Like, I wish I was there. I really wish I was there. Like, I'm so
you
far
wish.
Away from
I
it.
I wish to.
But at the same time, I have to admit, without understanding what the song is about, I cannot really relate to it,
mm-hmm.
I would say.
Okay.
Like, this is something that I'm missing. That I cannot... really feel into the emotion that he's singing.
Yeah.
So I want to find out what the song is about before I can judge it. But also I believe, like, in terms of Eurovision, you have to be snap. You have to be like, you have to make a very good first impression.
Mm-hmm.
And if it's staged in a way where you can't really understand, it's going to flop, just like Paloma did last year from Spain,
yeah.
which I really loved, and I really like. I took my time to understand, and I still am a huge fan of the song, and I'm a huge fan of herself. But I needed to get there without understanding what the song was about, and without people telling me about everything that I had missed from the song. I was not able to really relate to it. Now I appreciate the artistic value of it.
There is some for sure.
There is a lot of that. But like, you have to spend some time researching that. And with Eurovision, it's a little bit difficult because you cannot really have that time to,
mm-hmm.
to understand that without actually spending some time in the toilet during the party and just googling the lyrics or whatever.
Yeah.
I also feel like this song is very short.
Does it, is it?
It's, I think, one verse, one chorus, one verse, one chorus. Without a bridge. But I'm not sure. I was not paying attention that much.
Well, it says it all. It says it all.
It does.
So... the biggest asset is his voice. The other things are pretty mediocre. Nothing too extraordinary. They're pretty simple, pretty safe. But maybe this will be enough for France to reach a good position. We don't know. It may be, it may not.
I guess we're about to find out anyways.
In the following months, yeah.
I have to say, after time, I really warmed up to this song and I understand the appeal of it because his vocals are extremely strong. The performance is going to be probably quite minimalistic. You know, it's France. So it might really stand out from all of the other ones. And now we have Spain. Oh, is that Kylie Minogue? It must be Kylie Minogue. Say what you want, but it's a slay. Yes. Yes. She's amazing. And the song is actually like a little bit dark, but I love this synth pop, I guess this is how you call it. The song itself, great. Music video, I've seen better. Doesn't really have any storyline to it, which I like, but still, it's quite enjoyable. It really brings me back to the time when I was listening to a lot of Daft Punk, you know? And I'm not a huge fan of Kylie Minogue, to be honest. But recently, I have had my awakening to Kylie. So Spain is bringing a party this year. Yes, I'm definitely getting back to it. I love how happy everyone is. And you know, happiness spreads. Sorry, it made me feel like warm and fuzzy inside. You know, I'm checking the files as I go because I try to record all of those songs separately. And it seems that every time it starts okay, and then by the end of the recording, the sound doesn't match what you see. It just falls behind quite a bit. I don't really know how to help myself with that. So I'll continue and I'll just post whatever I can. The rest, unfortunately, will be gone forever. Anyways, let's continue with the United Kingdom. And there was a lot of fuss about it because Ollie Alexander, he was, I guess still is, a huge star, at least in the UK. It has good sound to it, but you know, we expect the best. It reminds me of the Spanish song as well. I would say this is a very radio-friendly song for sure. I'm not sure about the live performance. I don't know how he's going to stage it. I like the first part of the chorus. The rest, I'm honestly quite indifferent towards, but it's okay. I'm just curious now if it's going to build up a little bit or it's going to stay kind of this until the end. So it's like a love song, but it's trying to be dark. It's okay, but more of a radio song than a performance song. That's my conclusion. I like his vocal a lot. It's very like raspy and rocky. It's a little bit more like indie songs, I would say. Again, I would say this is one of those songs that fits into the radio-friendly category rather than performance category. It's going to be really difficult to stage it in a way that makes it really interesting. Or interesting enough for people to vote for it. I would say it's a very typical song. Like, nothing extraordinarily special. Nothing, like, let's say weak or bad. It's just okay, and it can go both ways from here. It can go really high, or it can go really low. Which would be a shame, because I do really think he has really good potential in him. Of course, it's going to be like really well produced, and it's a live performance as well. Is that the same guy? They look like brothers. Sorry, I was confused with their looks. They must be brothers, right? Okay, I'm warming up to it a little bit now, because I didn't really like it at first that much, because I was, you know, confused with the... Sorry, I have to stop it because I cannot think straight, as if I were. You know, all of my attention went to the visuals. I didn't listen to the song that much. I was just confused with the them being brothers or not being brothers, and with everything that was going on the stage. This one is a very much performance song. It's not like radio friendly that much. I understand the appeal of it. Not necessarily does it appeal to me that much, but that's just because I don't like perfect things. This is too perfect for me. I like the stage now. A plane is coming, that's why the internet is not working. Just for your information. It's a little bit too manufactured for me. But it's okay. It's like compared to some songs that we've heard in the recent years, it's definitely better. Like, you cannot compare them to this level of performance and this level of song production and everything. It's just that it lacks a little bit of soul for me, I would say.
My favorites were definitely Spain and Italy. Those two. I want to watch them every day, all day. Like, yes, 100% yes, as I've said during the recording. Sweden, France, Germany, the UK. You know, these are really good songs. It's just that they are not necessarily my type. Everyone has their type. And I also think that the live performances, they can convince you otherwise from what you've seen first. But when it comes to the first reaction, I do really have to admit that Spain and lovely, lovely, lovely Italy, they just stole my heart completely today. If there is anything that you would wish to discuss with me, or you would want to teach me about those songs, because as I said, I didn't really have any time to get that much into the detail of the production and of the lyrics and of the story behind them. So just let me know, so when it comes to today, that's about it. Thank you very much for joining me for this troublesome journey, and I really hope to see you in two other ones. Bye.